الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We started to read the hadith of the definitions that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave to the good deeds we do. So the hadith عن أبي مالك الحارث ابن عاصم الأشعري رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الطهور شطر الإيمان. Cleanliness and purity is half the faith, is part of the faith. It's a sign of the person have faith to be clean. Clean, as we say, physically and spiritually, externally and internally. The clean, they don't watch, they don't hear, they don't speak, they don't involve in this, that anybody and any culture says that is just rough, that is wrong, that is obscene, that is vulgar, that is not nice. So they say, you know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to come and just the minute they mention the name of somebody is not there, he puts his finger in his ears. He just wait, leave my heart, you know, in the same state. Wait, don't speak about somebody who's not here. Because no matter who you are, what you hear affects your heart. What you see affects your heart. This, you cannot control this. Second one, Alhamdulillah, tamla il mizan. Being grateful and thankful and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciates Allah's favor, will fill the scale of good deed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, always when you want to compare, because human compares, you want to compare your situation, compare to those who are less fortunate than you. Else, you're going to absolutely not appreciate anything Allah gives you. Yeah? What is the media and the magazines and culture and movies and everything says? They show us palaces. They show us not real life. It's not real on TV. It's not real life. It's all edited. It takes years to make this movie. Yeah? And stop and repeat and take one and take two and the same scene to get it perfect to affect you. But you think it is real and kids think it's real and yeah? Your house you live in comes all yucky carpet, yucky bathroom, yucky this, yucky that. And there is people in cardboard box on the footpath in Lambton Quay. You don't think like that. Yeah, you don't think of those who are running around from home to home, somebody is hosting them or feeding them. Yeah? Where is the dignity of those people? So the Prophet ﷺ is saying, when you want to compare, always compare those less fortunate than you. Your scale of good deed will be full. Subhanallah. It will fill your books of records with good deed because you're grateful. And then he says, ﷺ, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. You always have these two together. This is like La ilaha illallah. Subhanallah. Is like denying anything imperfect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attribute. Alhamdulillah is declaring the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, if you say and believe and live by subhanallah, Allah is perfect, everything He does is perfect. Walhamdulillah, everything He does is praiseworthy. It will fill the space between heaven and earth for you with good deeds. تَمْلَ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءُ وَالْأَرْضِ. It is just amazing amount, you can't put number on them. And then he says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَالصَّلَاةُ نُورِ. Salah is your light. The light that you see this life. The light that will fill your grave. The light that will fill this life for you. The light in the hereafter when everything is dark. Salah, the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الصَّلَاةُ نُورِ. It will absolutely is light, so you can see. Allah says, "Inna salatanha anil fahsha wal munkar wal baghi." Salah should be a reminder, alarm every time in your mind, your heart says, "Oh, that's not. This is suspicious." Because you just finished salah, you're going for another salah. It's always the believers just finish, or oh, when is dhuhr time? Yeah, and it's another 2 hours, another 3 hours. So the believers always in this reminder, I'm going to talk to Allah. How can I make these horrible mistakes in between? So the salah is the light that will show us the way, the right way, the right path in this life, in the hereafter. Was sadaqah. What about sadaqah? The Prophet ﷺ is amazing. He says, sadaqah is burhan, is a proof that you are a true believer. Because everybody, by creation, we love money. We just love it, you know. It's just something that human being made to acquire. If you give what you love to someone else, it means you love that action more than the money. And that's what we give. We give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, sadaqah, to give sadaqah, to give in charity, it is just a proof that you are true believers. You're not miserly or stingy or selfish. You love yourself more than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as-sabru diya. Sabr, patience and perseverance and holding on, it is a type of light that will have pain also. You have to have some, you know, bitter taste and feeling when you are controlling your emotion and not reacting. It is similar to salah, but salah is comfortable light, easy, peaceful light. But sabr, similar, but with a bit of, you know, efforts, with a bit of struggle, with a bit of pain. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take the pain from us. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Qur'an, and we finish with this one, Al-Qur'an hujjatan laka aw alay. Qur'an will not be right in the middle, will be either for you or against you. It's not just an idle thing. Either a proof for you or against you. Al-Qur'an hujjatan laka, it will become as evidence supporting you or again, it says, Ya Allah, he didn't even care what's in the Quran. Allah, he didn't even read, he didn't even listen, he didn't even bother. Yeah. So it's a very serious reminder that the Prophet ﷺ is telling us in between the words to look after the Quran relationship, to study the Quran, to listen to the Quran, to have it in our daily life. Listening, memorizing, understanding, studying, reading, this is, you know, the Quran. Making dua from the Quran, trying to see what the Quran says every day. Just have a look. One line, 5 minutes every day. We're not saying you leave everything. No, it's a time where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying it's hujjah laka. It will be evidence for you or against you. May Allah subhanahu wa taala make us from the people of Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa taala make it easy for us to understand the Quran, to live by the Quran, to memorize the Quran, to study the Quran, and to read the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and protect us and protect our family. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and to help our family. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our knowledge and iman and taqwa. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fill our life with ease and happiness and success and His pleasure. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept us and to accept from us. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Jazakumullah khairan.